The seamless interchange between web ad hoc grids and ad hoc grids in SmartView allow for flexible ways to work with and analyze data by focusing on data slices. The redesigned ad hoc grid is available in Oracle EPM Cloud Planning, Tax Reporting, and Financial Consolidation and Close. Perform ad hoc analysis with module-based, custom, and freeform planning applications. Here are the roles you need to perform ad hoc tasks. Let's see how we can set the display and behavior of ad hoc grids in user preferences. When performing ad hoc operations, member inclusions lets you perform operations such as zoom, keep, or remove only on the selected member and the members retrieved as a result of the operation, and a selected group of members, leaving unselected cells as is. Set the default level to zoom in. Display the order of ancestors or members in the hierarchy from highest to lowest or lowest to highest. Select whether you want to display member labels as distinct member name only, which shows the member's fully qualified names, or display member labels as member name or alias. If there is more than one alias table in the application, you can select which one to use with ad hoc grids. Set how member hierarchy levels are indented. By default, data is refreshed as you work in ad hoc. You can select Navigate without refreshing data if you want to refresh data on demand while performing ad hoc operations. With suppression, hide rows or columns containing zeros, rows with repeating members, rows or columns with missing data, rows or columns that you don't have access to. For position, select to apply the position setting of the currency member or set the minimum and maximum number of decimal positions to display in a cell for currency values, non-currency values, and percentage values. In replacement, set labels to display for cells that are missing data that you don't have access permission to view or that have invalid data. Make sure you save your selections. You create ad hoc grids from a dashboard, form, or cube. First, let's see how we can create an ad hoc grid from a dashboard. From the Forms action menu, select Analyze. Here's the ad hoc grid created from the dashboard's form. The initial grid is based on the form's layout. Next, let's open a form. From the Actions menu, you can select to take the current form into ad hoc analysis or create a new ad hoc grid. Now, I'll create an ad hoc grid from a cube. In Data Entry, click Create and select Ad Hoc Grid. Then, select a cube. By default, dense dimensions are in the rows and columns. The rest of the dimensions are in the POV. Set general grid properties in the property panel. You can change the grid name and the cube you're working with. Display member label defaults to My Selection in User Preferences Ad Hoc Options. In Ad Hoc Options, you can view or modify default selections from user preferences. Recently selected options persist when you return. In Layout, position dimension members by dragging and dropping them between the POV and the grid. View the Designing Ad Hoc Grids tutorial for steps in selecting members, moving dimensions, and other ad hoc grid features. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.